Web Sports Season 2-4 again. It's time to go for game 2 in this challenge of all teams. I played the Bobcat. I think I'm going to skip a team. I'm going to play the Bobcats last game. Let's see. I'm going to try and skip a team. Oh, yeah, skip Philly. I should play with them first. Okay. I've got the numbers come first before the letters, so doggone it. Last time I played with the Bobcats, beat the Knicks. Now I might get the Spurs. I've never played with Philly at all. First time with Philly. What do we got? Evan Turner. I look pretty decent. See if we can get down. See how we can get down. A lot of people definitely haven't asked me to play with Philadelphia, so it's what for you guys. For my Philly people out there. Let's go. All teams challenge. They're all teams. So far, 1-0. So for the Spurs, the all teams their last challenge. Game,
a win against the Lakers in Los Angeles. And I don't think I was the only one surprised, not just by their win, but guys, by what an emphatic win it was.
They won that game at the offensive end, guys. It almost seemed like they got something out of every possession down the floor.
And Steve, the few times they did come up empty, it didn't really carry over. They never lost their momentum.
Of course, I'd be the one to miss Nick Young out there. Everybody else would be just knocking down three and left and right with Nick Young.
Then it's Evan Turner.
Knock out man, Jack wanted to miss with him. I'll get on that. That's all day. Now let Tony Parker get mid-range. That is all day.
Tim Duncan, Tiago Splitter, the duo inside. And it's Leonard in at the free slot.
There have not been a lot of years where the 76ers have missed out on the playoffs, Kevin. I mean, overall, the franchise has done a really good job of keeping the down years to a minimum.
We'll go back to the title
in a number of those seasons. You don't need much range to hit from that distance, Kevin.
Now let's find out what head coach Doug Collins had to say to Doris Burke.
There we go.
Yes, Kevin, his focus coming into this game is on circumventing a very formidable defense, telling me they
Thank
don't
you.
Have many breakdowns at that end, so you really have to earn your points. Of course, we'd love to shoot a high percentage.
That's terrible.
If we can't, we've got to find a way to get more possessions, whether that's with rebounding or forcing turnovers.
Now he's taking terrible shots and making
them. He's counting on hustle plays to help them out.
Thank you, Doris, and quite a focus on the game here early on, and an important one too, guys.
It's
going to be to take on this defense. They've got to
get him blown up
on that aspect right away.
Well, that's the priority in the scouting report. You face a team this good defensively, you're thinking about how we need to attack it. Then it's a matter of executing once you get out there.
Well, back to what you were saying about the 76ers, Mark, even with all the coaching changes they've had in the last decade, they've always been in the mix, somewhere, somehow, and especially now with Doug Collins. Steve, we know a lot about him, don't we?
Yeah, one of the best coaches in the league, great broadcaster.
That's good D.
Even better coach.
Dang!
He really turned that team around, turned that franchise around.
Talk more to talk to the referee, man. Come on, get the ball inbounds.
Here's Holiday, following the basket by Tim Duncan. Holiday dishes to Turner. Back to Holiday.
Oh, come on, Holiday.
Hold on the shot. Got him on the way up that
damn
time.
One, baby.
So shoot two right here.
Well, you know, the Spurs have been thinking about what's beyond the Tim Duncan era in the future. But Duncan keeps on
taking they had Bynum.
Keeps playing at a very high level.
So have some kind of low post.
As long as he does that, San Antonio will be tough to beat.
No.
Kicks to Duncan.
Good day. There we go.
Thaddeus Young grabs the miss. 76ers have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Young for three.
Oh, he's two
a funny player, guys. I mean, he's given away a lot of inches, a few inches anyway, and still finds a way to win those rebound battles.
Hey, Splitter's hurt now. Get him out of there.
Goes on Evan Turner. That is his first
y'all dig on, make sure y'all got dag on. Westbrook got the game on the first dag on. Soon as he got hurt, the other people get that Splitter. He should be out too.
Here's Parker.
averaging 20 points per game. The feed to Green. Back to Parker.
Oh, we take that.
Fires for three.
Oh, we took them all day. Miss.
And going back to Tim Duncan and San Antonio, Clark, even if
oh.
he isn't
oh,
putting
go.
Up great
there we
numbers,
go.
He really does seem to drive the team just
there
through
you
his
go.
Power and his will.
Well, there's something about presence, and that's really what a superstar player like Duncan can do for you, Kevin. Even if
got
he plays into his 40s, I just can't imagine the Spurs not being competitive
out there.
With him
oh,
on their roster.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
Green kicks to Splitter. Shoots from the baseline.
Take them all day.
That's a shot that he sometimes struggles with, but you can't fault him for taking it when the defense backs off like that.
Here's Turner. No good.
They're trying to fill this team.
Spurs going the other way now.
Is it all good? Is it all good? Adjusting me. Oh, shit.
Where they were unable to fight
off
the 76ers.
Well, when you think about Evan Turner, you think about the ball handling, the passing, the rebounding. Second overall pick back in 2010. He's really
we're running with him. We're running with him.
That's been his only weakness as a pro. But that's gotten better to me, and I think as you watch him develop over the next few years, it will improve dramatically.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game. And for Turner, the good news offensively is he's pretty good finishing close to the basket.
Yeah, his ball handling is tight. He's got a
what y'all think of the playoffs so far?
To him. He's got a good work ethic.
Lakers got swept.
Sometimes to a fault, but you
Lakers
like
got swept.
He cares and wants to be good.
Good defense. Ooh, that was a nice fade. That was a nice fade. That was good to fade on that.
So I think he's going to be really an outstanding pro.
Playoffs have been really enjoyable so far.
And here is Turner. Ginobili getting his three to go. Right, that's a two-pointer. Solid defense there from Ginobili. The Spurs have gone far ahead shooting the ball here in the first quarter.
Oh, get that.
The rebound by Turner.
I tell you what, the mid-range shot is not the easiest one to make. And when you've got daylight like he had there, I mean, those are shots you want to make.
Duncan, the pass to Neal. Back to Duncan.
We need something. We need a basket.
The 76ers lead
right here.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Shots good by Turner. And so it's San Antonio with it. Joseph dishes Denis. From past the arc.
Shit.
Duncan kicks to Janot.
Oh, good shot.
And that's
not gonna go. And that I think I might enjoy this series here. Playing all teams, even just playing teams I haven't played with yet. I haven't attempted to play with yet.
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And guys, what's your take on the 76ers so far?
And the defense has been key in building this lead. They've really clamped down hard.
They've done a nice job, Steve. I think challenging every shot, a hand up on every shot.
All fueled up. And
oh, good show. Good show.
Lineups, courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going. And so in the game for the 76ers, young out there with Spencer Hawes. Then there's
good
Nick Young.
Good
then
defense.
Evan Turner,
good
and
defense.
And Holiday in at the point guard position.
You know, the Spurs have always been built around Tim Duncan. But the last few years, they've added more depth.
I can't get one to go with Nick Young. He's not right.
So Greg Popovich is playing 9 or 10 guys. They're very deep. They play together.
That spin, doesn't air. The horses by is crazy like
than they ever were early in that era.
Here's Holiday after the made shot from Mono Ginobili.
Eagle Hall.
Chance points on the tip in. Hawes got his first bucket in this one.
And a nice soft touch on the board.
And you know, when you have that gentle touch, those tip-ins are easy to come by.
Well, well, any time out, coach.
Points for a guy with that kind of strength and agility in the paint, you got to go for every second chance opportunity.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here. And with the team getting older, you really need to have more depth. And the Spurs have certainly added that.
Young or old, every team needs depth, but the Spurs have added the right kind of depth. The players that fit into what they do well, and it's a big part of why they still are able to compete at a high level.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. Tim Duncan is checked in for Matt Barnes.
Green up, get up.
And Corey Joseph subbed in for Tony Parker.
Nice aggressive defensive play to make the steal and start the break.
Yeah, and I like the fact they didn't mess around with it once they got it.
Holiday attacking. The 76ers with another.
I have no flow with this team.
Spurs coach Greg Popovich, no question, one of the great coaches of all time, and a really interesting guy. I love the way he handles the media. He
can be funny
at one moment, surly the next. He keeps reporters on their toes. And a very sarcastic side to him.
And San Antonio has possession. Philadelphia able to drain.
Nobody will step up more. Timmy in his range. Nobody will step up.
They started the game off tortoise-like, but their offense coming to life.
Tortoise-like. Wow, Clark. Yeah, they're putting it together, but still trailing. Their offense is finally getting some traction.
Young from outside. Rebound, San Antonio. Duncan's got his third rebound on the night. And when you talk about the yin and the yang of Greg Popovich, you know, you have to say, Steve, he's done a great job over the years of being demanding, get what he, you know, needs out of the players he's coaching without causing much backlash. You know, the locker basically polices itself. He'll get hard, even on the Tim Duncans of the world.
There we go,
man. Hard on him and coach him.
Yeah, he gets on all of his guys, and I think that's the secret for Popovich. Having Tim Duncan and David Robinson over the years as the foundation of that organization. You know, those guys are high-quality players and high-character people. So to be able to build around them and to coach them allows Popovich to coach everybody else as well.
Here's what Philadelphia is going with right now. Mulcher's checked in for Hawks. Wright comes in for Evan Turner. And Damian Wilkins subbed in for Nick Young. And a fast break now for the Spurs. Goes right up. Up and in on the way. Splitter's got 4 points now in the quarter.
You know, most great teams are really built around one or two stars. And then surrounding that core. But
I can't wait to get this game over with. I am not having fun with this team here.
They've played the last few years with a group of young guys who are out
there. Luckily, I'm winning, though.
So, for the most part, it's been pretty successful. But again, so tough to win in this league at a high level without a star.
Holiday with it. Picked up by Joseph. The shot by Holiday. No good.
He got the shot he wanted off that pick. Just couldn't get it to fall.
Well, Steve, they'll take that play all day long, 10 times out of 10. That was good action.
Fires from the wing.
There you go, Drew.
And that one's good. And the 76ers lead by 5. And there are a group of teams that have found success, Steve, like that. You know, you can
good
point at teams
defense.
Like and the Indiana Pacers.
Let's go. Run it.
And certainly, Clark, the 76ers along that same vein.
You know, Kevin, as Steve said, it's hard to win without a star, and you wonder if Philly will eventually shake things up to bring somebody in of that level. But I'm not quite sold on the fact that you can't do it at a high level.
You made
really good, cohesive players.
Oh, Jesus. Yes. Just back there. Let's go back. Let's look at that.
Oh, I love it. Absolutely love it. You can almost hear the fans hold their breath when he takes off.
He is a true
ball. Oh, good block.
You don't want to be in
good
his
block
way on dunks like that one. That's
good
for
block.
Sure.
Young pass to right.
We're running now. Playing my type of game now. Defense and running. Defense and running. My type of game now. Playing my type of ball.
Well, they lost track of him and they paid the price.
Playing my type of ball now. Defense and running. Easy way to score. Play good defense.
Now the second half about to start up and begin any moment. One guy who's getting it done is Thaddeus Young.
That's been nothing but positive for this team. The way he's
been selective with his
shot making. He's been very unselfish. I think this has been an efficient performance for him.
I agree with you, Steve. Very few questionable decisions. From him as he has always looked for the best shot. Every trip down the floor, I mean, I like the fact that he's judicious in his approach.
So with Ginobili sitting on the bench, here's how the floor looks for Greg Popovich. Leonard and Duncan are the forwards. Tony Parker at the one and Danny Green at the two.
You guys on Splitter in at the Kawhi Leonard.
Manning the middle. Just five Lake, on the clock. Leonard. And it's blocked by Holiday. And that one's good. Duncan.
He exposed a flaw in the defense. No way they're supposed to be giving him that shot. Well, guys, as you know, I had a chance to play with Tim Duncan for 4 seasons in San Antonio.
Hey, if he pulled like that, I might use him a little more.
The skill level.
Thaddeus Young, let's go.
The leadership in the locker room. Just an absolute joy to play with.
Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. It's Parker with the drop. Gets it to go.
Such an aggressive player. I just love the way he explodes to the rim.
And the 76ers call time here. Steve, that's saying a lot. You play with Michael Jordan and Tim Duncan. That's not too bad on your resume. Clark, self-confidence, some would say ego, so often part of the makeup for professional athletes. With guys like Tim Duncan,
that humility to the hot man
can be refreshing.
It is refreshing, and it's also empowering to the people that he's around and with.
Damn.
The distinction to me between confidence and ego comes down to respecting other people and valuing what they bring. And that's who he is and what he's been about.
Back to the post. Well, how Britain Boy was for the last couple plays.
In Europe. Now in the NBA, he's really showing what he's got at both ends of the floor. An active big man, he can run the floor, he can rebound, block shots, and score a little bit as well.
Yeah, you know, a mobile seven-footer with a good basketball IQ, he's a factor on the offensive board, boosting that box score with those second-chance points. Young with the steal.
Heads up interior defense there. He was ready for that entry. Look out. Watch out now. Did you see that?
Oh, we got to see that one again, guys. We got to see that again.
I need a replay. I'm not sure what I just looked at.
Splitter kicks to Leonard. Young with the steal. And the foul call on Kawhi Leonard. That is his first foul of the game.
His first personal foul. First team foul.
Here's Young on the arc.
Calm slipping.
Good on the basket.
Calm slipping.
And it's a 12-point 76ers lead.
Coming out strong here in the third quarter. That's 4 for 5 shooting.
That's a good
team.
Shot. He missed the rebound. Out of bounds.
The Spurs will look to you as an annual threat to win it all, especially with Tim Duncan in his prime. But the last few years, people haven't taken San Antonio seriously, but they still win consistently, night in and night out.
Shots good from Young.
Work on that young man down there. Stop jumping. Just put your hands up. That's all you got to do.
And offensive execution has been the story here. Just playing beautiful basketball.
And guys, you can see it in their advantage in field goal percentage. I mean, you get high quality
shots. Get that shit out of here.
You're usually going to shoot well. They're playing outstanding basketball.
First ball.
Let's take a moment now, Kevin, to see how the Spurs are doing in the NBA statistics currently. First in assists, second in field goal percentage.
They're the third-ranked
team in free throw percentage. A number of players on that team are very comfortable
and
capable at the foul line.
Yeah, the one thing that really jumps out at me when you talk about all these stats, Clark, is the assists.
Uh-oh, he's on fire. Comes the heat check.
Unselfish. They're sharing the ball. They're moving. They're really getting a good flow to their offense. And as a result, they're finding pretty high percentage shots almost every possession.
Thinking about the Spurs, a lot of it just seems to be habit for them. Winning has certainly become a habit down in Texas.
Yeah, they have the players to compete, but by no means do they seem overpowering to any other team. Pop is a great coach, Greg Popovich, and gets the most out of them. And
Nicholas Young.
He's starting to heat up
in his mouth.
That's his second this half.
That didn't sound right.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
And Duncan gets it to go on the assist from Leonard. And that's now 10 points for Duncan. Now the 76ers with it. Big stretch here going 10-2. Holiday goes in. Takes a three.
Ooh.
Another three for Young. For three. And the 76ers win by 18.
Boy, they just cannot figure out a way to stop this guy this quarter, Kevin.
Here's Parker. Spencer Hawes grabs the miss. Hawes got his third rebound on the night.
He just can't get a good feel for his shot.
About to say, hit down there.
And the call will be against that.
Stop gunning with him.
That's foul.
That's why I come out cheesing the three pointers.
Some changes here for the Spurs. Matt Bonner, he's checked in for Splitter.
Yeah.
Ginobili comes in for Tim Duncan. And Gary Neal subbed in for Daniel Green. And then for Philadelphia, Moultrie's checked in for Hawes. Wright comes in for Thaddeus Young. And Damian Wilkins subbed in for Drew Holiday. Moultrie setting the pick for Young. And a miss there on the triple. Ginobili with the ball. He has 7.
What? Took a shot with Kawhi Leonard?
A three-pointer off the mark. Now the 76ers on the break.
Ooh, let's go.
He
He's definitely showing some real sweet dunking skills here.
Are you kidding me? Oh my God, what a play.
Yeah, that was spectacular.
And as we end the third, 31, the 76ers, 49.
All right. Fourth quarter. Good going.
On the court for Philadelphia to start the fourth. Evan
no way.
Up
nope.
With Young.
Nope.
Then there's
grab
Spencer
that.
Hall. Then it's Holiday. And
that's
it's Young.
Good.
And it's the two spot. And the basket by Ginobili. And there's the call on Ginobili. That is his first foul of the game. The 76ers leading by 16. It's Young on the wing. But three.
Oof.
Young's got 14 points now in the second half.
Tell you what, when he gets it going, this is exactly what can happen. They may have to double team him.
No,
here's
sir.
Ginobili. And Philadelphia grabs the miss.
Some rugged defense there against one of the stronger finishers in the game.
And it's Turner finishing it
no,
off.
Sir.
Nicely done. They've really attacked effectively in transition.
There's no doubt about it, Steve. Their quickness has given them an advantage. I mean, I've liked the
good
way they push the ball all game.
And it's slammed in by Splitter. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it.
Out the way.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over.
Well, he's watching his club miss a lot of shots than they normally make, and that has to be frustrating. So I think he's going to call this timeout just to try to see if they can be more aggressive, get them to the free throw line. Maybe.
Sometimes that's the best solution for them, but ultimately I think they'll be able to shoot themselves out of this slump. But in the meantime, maybe getting to the free throw line will help.
Here's Ginobili.
Goodness.
And it's blocked. And it's out of bounds. The Spurs able to retain possession here.
14 seconds on the shot clock.
And the Spurs with possession, trailing by 19. Young with the steal. Now the 76ers on the break. Holiday with the ball. And Nick Young, the bucket on the assist by Holiday. Young's got 24 points. Here's Parker. They get it again. He dishes it to bottom. But Trey.
Good shot.
Ball's nice feed that time for Miles Ginobili.
Well, the Red Rockets, as they call him, one of the best outside shooting big men that we've seen in this league the last few years. You cannot leave him open outside defensively.
Yeah, classic shooting four-man. His game is to spot up at the three-point line and wait for the open look.
Right
comes in for Evan Turner. Right. And the foul on Durrell Wright. That's his first foul. Parker kicks to bottom. And it's good on the assist by Parker.
How about that play? Great body control. Still manages to finish the play despite the contact.
You know, when that whistle blows, you're not done. Get greedy and find a way to knock it down.
Evan Turner, he's checked in for the 76ers.
Let's
gets it to go. And that's now 6 points for Drew Holiday.
Points in the paint have been the main course, or main entree, if you will. They just keep pounding it inside.
Well, they're seeing no resistance defensively in the paint area, so the defense has got to be tougher.
Ginobili dishes to bottom. Parker, right with the double team. Splitter passes to bottom. Shot clock at 2. Outside, Ginobili.
Rebound by
Drew Holiday. Young outside. Beyond the arc. Another 3 for Philadelphia.
Guy's been an artist with that 3-point shot.
Oh, man. I'm just messing on this dude saying I'm cheesy. That's all right, though. He's open.
Kicks to Ginobili for 3. And it's good on the assist by Parker. And that's 12 points for Ginobili.
He had one in the first as well. He's pretty dangerous. Keep an eye on him.
That one goes. Count.
I think they're trying to go for the kill here. I mean, they're starting to take a lot more 3-point shots than they had been before, looking to run away.
Yeah, that's, oh, that's fine
terrible.
As long as you're making them, but make sure you don't start launching bad shots. That's a problem.
That's now 6 straight points off open threes. Get a hand up, fellas. Pay attention to the scouting report.
Well, you know how quickly things can go south when you start giving up wide open looks to this.
All right.
Alright, back at it again.
And the Spurs making a change here. Duncan's checked in. And the 76ers also making a change. Thaddeus Young, he's checked in for Jarrell Wright. And that one's good. Parker.
Good work turning that into an easy two-point. He can attack the rim as well as anybody.
Too easy.
Holiday gets the bucket.
And they add to this lead, trying to close this game out.
I think it would take a lot of luck and maybe then some. I mean, might be time to pack this thing in.
It's up a three. And again, it's San Antonio with a three.
Another open look hits bottom from outside.
Yeah, and that's three of their last five makes from beyond the arc.
Young outside. And so it looks like the 76ers will retain possession here.
17 seconds on the shot clock.
Oh,
stolen by Ginobili.
Nope.
Over Holiday. Here's Splitter. Hits it. Yeah. Well done on the second.
No more.
The 76ers leading by 13. And Holiday, here we go. Turner up top. Over Parker. The shot by Turner, no good.
Very porous defense down there by the hoop. He probably should make that one.
No way.
Ginobili outside.
This fool here. Kicking my butt with Ginobili.
Like he's got every point in this
quarter. Oh, Jesus.
An amazing job helping to cut into this lead.
Tries again. No good. Now the 76ers take it the other way. 22 is their biggest lead. And Turner kicks to Young. Another miss by Philadelphia. And Clark, maybe at this point, not much of a chance for a comeback.
I don't think it's going to happen, partner.
Yeah, pretty unlikely to dig out of this hole, but you can't think that way. You got to just play it possession by possession.
Thaddeus Young on the wing.
Pretty let go.
Dishes to Hawks. Young outside.
Why not?
Launches it. Shot is off. Here's Parker. Misses.
2-0 so far.
So it's the 76ers
round the league.
This one
let's go. Sunday's card. Boy, see it 2-4. At it again. Yes, sir.